Kia ora and malolele. My name is Essendon Tuitupou. I am the director of the Front Foot Apps Development Project and Competition. It's my great privilege and honour to welcome you to the video announcing the winner of the 2021 Front Foot Apps Competition. This year we were incredibly proud and privileged to start this program where we're trying to encourage as many of our young Pasifika and South Auckland community and West Auckland community schools to get involved in STEM to a greater degree. What we've done with our program Front Foot is actually to challenge our young people to find solutions to challenges that they see within their own community, and then to develop an app concept that would be able to resolve and actually address some of those issues. Some of the ideas and some of the creativity that's come through from our young people in this program has been outstanding. And we're really grateful and thankful that 40 teams were able to enter this year's competition. And from those 40 teams, we've drawn it down to four. And today you're going to be able to see the four semi-finalists, the schools that they represent, and also a presentation of their app idea. Now, one of the great things about anything to do with technology is our young people are quick to pick it up. But often what's missing is then the next stage of not only having a great idea, but how you develop a great idea into actually a working model that's actually practical and has a real world application to it. With our Front Foot Apps program, what we've been able to do is been able to partner with some incredible agencies and be funded to a great level of generosity by some good partners that we'll talk about later on in this video. But what we want to do at this point in time is just to acknowledge the fact that this program and this competition could not have been held this year without the help and the assistance of so many different people and so many different agencies. And we are grateful and we thank you for that. It's been a challenging year with COVID and we've had to adapt and change our styles and change our processes. But the main thing that's come through is just the versatility and the resilience of our young people and their ability to be able to get on with actually finding a solution and completing a task that's been set before them. So we're going to talk now about the semi-finalists, and we're going to go through each of them, and they're going to present their ideas and present their concepts. And then at the end of the video today, I'm going to announce the winner for 2021. So we're going to start off our presentations. We're going to look to hear from Rise Up Academy and Papatoi West.
Manatu mai au.
Manatu mai au.
Remember me.
Our app is designed for people with dementia, particularly the elderly, our grandparents. It helps them remember their family members and those close to them. It also helps with routines and can also be in their own language. Our app was inspired by our relationship with our grandparents and how dementia causes them to remember us only sometimes. At least with this app, they can see us in photos, videos, and speak to us in our mother tongue.
Coming up with the app was the hardest part of the plan. We had so many great ideas, but we really wanted to come up with a unique plan. We originally were going to go with pollution until one of our teachers heard our cry for help. She gave us the idea of how we could help elderly people with dementia. As she spoke the words, we loved it. As soon as we could, we started working on the screenplays. We wrote down how we could help them and what they were having trouble with. A few weeks later, after sending our idea in, we got an email saying we made it in to the finals. So we were so grateful for our teacher, Miss Grace, who gave the idea.
Thank you, Steve, Miss Key, and Miss Grace for all the help and effort they have put into helping us.
We are so grateful that we got chosen to represent Rise Up Academy.
Working with Steve was such an honor and a great experience.
In other ways, this was a lifetime opportunity.
Thank you for all the help.
Kia ora, talofa. My name is Rayleigh Mariner, and I attend Public Tory West School. I am one of the creators of a new exciting app called The Walking Waka. I am here today to tell you a little more about it. The Walking Waka is an app that allows students and parents to organize their journey to and from school, all while being safe. We designed this app because our group saw that there is a need in our school community. We have a lot of traffic around our school, which can be dangerous and also harmful for the environment. We have been encouraging our students to walk to school, as it's a healthy alternative to driving. The app will work by having each child wear a lanyard to track them walking to school. Parents can access the app to see if their children are okay. We hope that students and parents connect to create our own school walking waka. This app promotes 1, walking to school safely, 2, healthy lifestyles and exercise, 3, reduces pollution, and 4, less traffic around school. Thank you for listening to my presentation on the new awesome app, The Walking Waka.
Hey, that's great to hear from the ideas that's come from Papatoi West and also from Rise Up Academy. Now, before we hear from our last 2 semi-finalists, again, we just want to acknowledge just the generous support of so many different agencies. A number of them we'll be able to list, and you'll see them being mentioned and their logos at the end of this video. But we really want to acknowledge particularly our partnership with Pasipika and IT to Torvia and his crew. This program couldn't have been done without their assistance and their support. We appreciate everything that Pasi IT have done for us, and we're looking forward to just a really good relationship and partnership into the future. Secondly, we also want to acknowledge the Ministry of Pacific Peoples and also the Ministry of Education for just funding support to get this program off the ground. We're really excited and we're encouraged by what we're able to achieve, and hopefully what we're looking to be able to do into the future is to be able to actually highlight and showcase to a greater audience just the amazing work that our young people do and their ability to do great things. So we're going to move on now to the next 2 semi-finalists, and it's my privilege now to present to you the presentations from Alfriston School and also Flatbush.
Hi, my name is Fiona.
Hi, my name is Eleanor.
Hi, my name is Cormac.
Hi, my name is Shuzi.
Big brainstorm of things we thought would help. We then decided on the 3 we thought would help the most. A space for young people to talk, a place to track how you were feeling, and a place to write. We decided that we would use emojis to track how you were feeling.
Each element of the app onto post-it notes. We changed the flow of the design many times. Then Paul introduced us to a program called Mockups, which none of us have ever heard of before. We began using mockups to change our post-it notes into the design of a proper app. Soon we were pros at using mockups.
And to focus on specific elements to make them great. Me and Susie worked on the emoji tracker, while Eleanor and Selena worked on the notes and journals, and Wendy and Fiona worked on the main points, let's talk.
On the emoji tracker, you can record your moods and see a history of your moods as well as your specific statistics. In the notes and journals, you can write down anything you want or need to write down, but in case you can't, there are prompts to help you. In the let's talk element, there are resources for you to get professional help as well as a way to contact someone.
I'd like to give a huge thank you to Paul for helping us the entire process of making the app and the endless things. We learned so much about designing apps and the process to making it. We built skills relating to working in groups with different ages and abilities.
Learning how to use a brand new program and learning lots of skills relating to app development. We know the app will make a difference for our young people and their mental health.
So our biggest challenge was all of the COVID restrictions because we're in Auckland. So with that, it meant that we couldn't be as close together as we normally would. We couldn't work as close together. We had to do a lot of our work over Zoom, and we had to learn a lot of stuff over Zoom, which was challenging for us, wasn't it, Fiona?
Yeah, it was.
we weren't able to have normal conversations as it would be this past year. This COVID was really challenging.
Our strengths were that we all worked together very well and we all took each other's feelings into consideration.
And certain members of our team were really good at design and other members were quite good at other things, like setting out ways to do things.
Advice we would give to anyone who is trying to make an app is to start slow. Don't try and make solutions to problems around the world and just start around the community.
Identify problems that don't have solutions, find some solutions and have fun. Like, it's a really fun thing.
If we could do anything differently next time, I think it would be to be more hands-on from the start and get involved early.
And actually,
because we had ideas early on, but we couldn't implement them for a little while.
And actually get on time and work together more often.
Hello, Falava. My name is Ja. I come from Flatbush Primary School, and today I'll be introducing you to our app called Stop Bullying. This app that Rick, Thomas, and I worked on is very useful for reporting bullying. As soon as you download it and you press on it, I will lead you to a sign in and a sign up page. As soon as you finish that process, it will lead you to a page with three buttons: location, guide, and report. Location is where you have to put yourself on the map. Guide leads you to a friend named Frankie. Frankie will explain how to use the app. Report will lead you to a page with location, who, and what. Location is where the bullying happened. Who was the person who did it? What is what type of bullying? Did he punch you, kick you, slap you, or push you? And when you're done, you will have to press submit. And when you press submit, it will be sent anonymously to school or police. Thank you for your support.
Wow, it's amazing. Those are some really, really incredible concepts, incredible ideas from all our semi-finalists. But also, we do want to acknowledge all the other schools that have been part of this program, that have been entered and unfortunately just couldn't make it through to the semi-finals. But you'll see that the standard has been pretty high to get to this level, and we're excited in terms of being able to announce the winner and to see what their app would look like as we develop it. So without further ado, I know you've been waiting a while for this, and many teams and many schools have been part of this to get to this point. So I would like to congratulate Alfriston School for being this year's 2021 Front Foot Apps competition winners. But on top of that, we the judges have been so impressed by just the level of work and the level of creativity has gone through. We're actually going to award another winner who we will also help them develop their app idea as well. And to the kids at Rise Up Academy, congratulations, well done. You too will have your app developed, and we're excited to work with you on such an incredible idea of helping our grandparents and our family members that are struggling with dementia through this app idea that you've created. So congratulations both to Alfriston and also to Rise Up Academy, our 2021 winners. And commiserations to Papatoi West and also to Flatbush and all the other schools that have entered. But look, we're excited about next year. We're going to have many more teams entered. We're going to take it to another level. And also, you're going to see the apps that have been developed, or the ideas that have come through this year being fully developed in time, so that next year's entries can be inspired and be motivated by what we are able to achieve through this Front Foot Apps competition. So take care. Merry Christmas, everyone. We can't wait to see you guys in the new year. And we just say God bless to you all.